So this machine is called NIOX, and what I'm going to be doing is measuring your FeNO. Now, FeNO stands for fraction of exhaled nitric oxide. Now, everybody exhales nitric oxide, but if you've got inflammation in your airways, then your levels are going to be higher. Mm-hmm. And people with asthma exhale more nitric oxide than those without. So what I'm hoping is this will give me a number that will make me think, yes, I'm right about what I clinically think. Okay. So if the number is less than 25, that would be a normal level. Between 25 and 50, it's an intermediate level. And what that means is, yes, you may well respond to inhaled corticosteroids. If the level is 50 and above, that means you're highly likely to respond to inhaled corticosteroids. Okay. So what I'm going to be asking you to do is, this is the mouthpiece. You'll be breathing out until you've emptied your lungs. You're then going to put your mouth around this bit here at the top, and you are going to breathe in. As you're breathing in, what you'll see is these orange circles that are going to fill up. When they are full, you then breathe out. Now, you will feel a resistance, so you've sort of got to work with it. And then this arrow that's here, what you're going to see is it's going to move into the green area. That's where we want you to keep it. So you've got to maintain that same resistance throughout. And the test will take 10 seconds, so you'll be breathing out for 10 seconds. Mm-hmm. All right. So hold this. So I want you to breathe out and empty your lungs. And now put it to your mouth and suck. So keep breathing in. You can see these are filling up. Right now it's full, so I want you to push. Breathe the air out a little bit harder. A little bit harder. Fantastic. So that's a nice steady tone. Keep it there in the green. And that's nice and steady. That's beautiful. Now that means that the test is complete.
Oh, right, okay.
So over already. Now there's just a minute where it's counting down to get your result.
Yeah.
How did you find that?
That was a lot less force, a lot gentler than doing the spirometry we did before.
Yeah, you struggled with that a little bit.
That was
we
harder,
found it
yes.
difficult to actually get consistent results that we knew that the numbers were going to be correct. So, but you found that okay?
Yes, it was a lot easier to do than before.
Yeah. Yeah. And did you like the screen, the way that you've got that?
I found it, once I got the force to blow hard enough, I could keep it in the green. So once we'd had a try and got the and blew hard enough, it was nice and steady.
Yeah. And then that sort of tone helps you keep it there, doesn't
so
it?
So will that result be on the screen then?
It will. It'll flash up, and so we'll get an automatic answer. Mm-hmm. And then, obviously, in line with sort of your history and the signs and symptoms that we've been discussing today, that's going to give us an idea about whether you will respond to inhaled corticosteroids or not.
Is this something that you'd need to repeat with me at some point?
So what I'll do, let's have a look and just wait for the number and then I'll be able to answer that. Right, so that is 27. Mm-hmm. Okay, so that's put you in that intermediate category where you may well respond to inhaled corticosteroids. So I think because based on your history, it would be a good idea to get you on a trial of inhaled corticosteroids. And then in answer to your question about repeating the test, what I'd like to do is have you back in 4 to 6 weeks. I'll be finding out whether your symptoms have improved, and we will also repeat this test.
Okay.
And what I will be hoping is that actually it's gone back to a normal level, which would be below 25.
Thanks. That's great. Thank you.